Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Hasti and today I'm going to share with you a recipe which is different from most recipes that I've shared. It is not a food recipe. With the coronavirus pandemic that has gripped us all, we all have become more alert. We have started going out and buying personal health and hygiene products, because of which hand sanitizers have been depleted in the market. You can't find them anymore. That is the reason that I am sharing this recipe with you guys. But remember that hand sanitizer is not the total solution to hand washing. It is not an alternate to hand washing for 20 seconds with water and a germicidal soap. That is what WHO or World Health Organization dictates. But if you are in a situation where you can't find water, clean water or soap, then you can go ahead and use this hand sanitizer. Now, I am not a pharmacist or a registered medical professional, but I am using the recipe that I found on the World Health Organization website. And it is actually, all the chemicals that I used are also very easily available. So I'm sharing this recipe with you, but it is not a replacement for commercial sanitizer as well. So if you are able to find commercial sanitizer, then you should use that. But this recipe is there to protect you in emergency situations so that you are not left without any way to guard yourself from the harms and the danger of coronavirus. So let's begin making this recipe. So this is the first ingredient, that is glycerin. I have just bought it from a regular pharmacy store. It is a clear liquid like this and it's actually very easily available. This is the most important ingredient or the main disinfectant that is used in the hand sanitizer. It is called isopropyl alcohol and it is easily available at any medical store. Right now it is in stock, but it also is used for disinfecting a lot of things. This is the spirit that doctors use to rub on your skin before they give you an injection. So this is easily available and it is one of the main ingredients. This is the third ingredient. This is hydrogen peroxide. You must have heard of this. It is also used as a bleaching agent. This is also a very powerful disinfectant, but it is also easily available commonly in pharmacies, and you guys should be able to get hold of it very, very easily. This is a 5-7% solution of hydrogen peroxide. This is pure aloe vera gel. It does not have any other additives in this. And this is what we are going to use as base for the gel type of the hand sanitizer. I am using this sterilized glass bowl. I have heated this with boiling water for 10 to 15 minutes. And I have also heated this in boiling water for 10 to 15 minutes. Then I have removed it from boiling water and let it air dry for half an hour till all the water drips off. And then I have just cleaned it with a lint-free cloth. So this equipment has been sanitized. And these are the two bottles that I am going to use. I'm going to use this spray type bottle to fill in the liquid sanitizer and this pump type bottle to fill in the gel sanitizer. And I have washed this with Dettol and some warm water. Since they are plastic, I am not boiling them with hot water, but I have washed them in warm water with Dettol and also let them air dry. So this is 187.5 ml of isopropyl alcohol, or this Sergilin or surgical spirit that I have taken in this bowl. To this I'm going to add 10 ml of hydrogen peroxide. Then I'm going to add in 3.5 grams or about 4 grams of this glycerin. So that is about one capful of glycerin. And lastly, this is the spray type of sanitizer that I'm making. So to this I'm going to add 250 ml of boiled water. This is the boiled water. I have boiled the water for 20 minutes. Let it boil at that temperature for 20 minutes and then shut off the gas and let it cool down, come to room temperature, and then you are ready to use it. That's it, the sanitizer is ready. I'm just stirring everything together so that the alcohol and the glycerin is well mixed, and then you can bottle this into the spray type bottles that I showed you earlier, in this kind of bottle. Another thing is that if you want, you can also add some fragrance to this. You can use some pure essential oils. Don't use artificial chemicals. You can use pure essential oils like lavender or lemongrass, which will make this more aesthetically pleasing. But you can also keep it odorless. It has a slight alcohol surgical spirit smell, and you can use it as it is as well. Now I'll make the gel based sanitizer. For that I am just going to use half the proportions of the isopropyl alcohol, glycerin and hydrogen peroxide. Then add in 5 grams of the hydrogen peroxide and about 2 grams of glycerin. And to this, I'm going to add this entire tub of aloe vera gel, which is about 150 grams. I'm just going to mix all this till it forms a homogeneous mixture. So as you can see, after some mixing, it was initially quite liquidy, but now it has become proper and in gel form. So you will need to mix the aloe vera well with the alcohol solution. You can use a whisk that has been sterilized, and that will give you this result faster.